think you and I were talking about how there's a story that's connected to that song. And I think we would like to hear it, because I haven't heard it myself.
Yeah, so this story is adapted from the ancient traditional culture of China. It's called the Chuzi. So behind the story is a lovely love story. So it's a senior girl. She does not the royal family, she just a common people. She fall in love with a prince. You know, at ancient times, it's very hard to reach the royal family. But she wrote a love letter to the prince, and then the prince got his letter. And then they kind of connect to each other's feelings. So back then is a very lovely love story. So when everybody hear that, the Yue Ren Ge, the song of Yue.
Thank you.
music, folk music, as well as originally composed. You will notice that purposefully there are no dates of birth or death attached to the composer's names, because the only non-living composer will appear later in the program, but everybody else is living a triumph. So, but in addition to the music inspired or born in the culture of China or other Asian countries, we also have a few offerings that I'd like to present as crossroads of West and East, whether it's intentional or we decided to make it so. So, and the next piece is the setting of a famous spiritual text of the Irish blessing by the British composer Colin Davie.
Thank you.
So it's hard to imagine. Many Asian cultures, you know, without cherry blossom. So we blossomed a little bit earlier, slightly ahead of the time. But if you notice around you, there, even in downtown Seattle, there's already a few trees that are starting to show flowers. Kevin and I, recently had a little conversation. And I found it fascinating when she told me that Pipa and the whole kind of movement of Pipa, and as much as to be trained to be an excellent performer, you still probably want to study in China with the Chinese greatest masters. But there are cultures right next to their borders that seem to have more appreciation for Pipa, like Japan. And I found it very fascinating. So as a nod to the culture of Japan and their adoration of cherry blossom, we have the next song. that song because it was written by an old and tested classic composer that a lot of people admire, Andrzej Dvorak. I don't think even he himself would imagine, you know, the kind of sauce or the fusion that one day his famous humoresque would become. Please enjoy this next offering from the this fascinating blend of Western and Asian cultures.
Thank you. Yeah.